Hey guys, Tyra here, bringing you a 1v1 today. We are on Colodny Firma Summer. Playing for two, spawning on the right is me. I use Ostia in my loadout. There's Lightning War, Mechanized Assault, and Blitzkrieg. I usually don't use mobile defense. Just if I lose that early game, as Ostia that badly that I need the Puma.
Ready for
Let's
action.
call the game a write-off, really. And honestly, with the 2-2-2 in such a strong position as it is now, if you get double 2-2-2s, you kind of, excuse me, kind of almost don't even need the Puma these days. On the left, we have Tomokaze playing as US forces. And his loadout is Recon Support, Armor Company, and Rifle Company. So yeah, getting my pioneers to put down some wire whilst they do the capping machine gun onto the munitions, expecting this to be the first location for an engagement. But if not, the grenadiers are here through the center, which would allow me to rotate my machine gun. And here comes some riflemen charging down the road. At the same time, rear echelon going for the munitions point. Just gets shut down hard by the machine gun. A squad coming in for the flank, but the pioneers are there. Grenadiers rotating now. They're already taking quite a lot of damage here. So things going pretty poorly for Tomokaze straight away. See my machine gun here. Suppress them, and that's the end of his. So we see an extremely early mortar for US forces. I mean, for Tomokaze rather. We see a lot of players going for three rifles into the mortar. He's making it even earlier than that, and this thing still probably overperforming a little bit, especially against Aussie with those four men squads. Perhaps its auto attack is a little bit too strong still. Here we go, straight away auto attack gets a nasty, nasty hit on this grenadier squad, forcing them to retreat. Now I was expecting this squad to come around this side, which is why I had my machine gun facing in that direction, but they didn't. They came back around here. But that's alright, because there's only one window out of this this side. So any engagements you take from behind this heavy cover here is generally pretty good. Also got one model shooting from the Blitz guys, but still a very good engagement for me. And so he's, I mean, Tomokaze bringing up mortar now to try and blast away at this.
Riflemen are now equipped with
doing the old pop in, pop out trick. See how fast the barrage is on that thing. So it's very good at dislodging machine guns, but as I was saying, probably shouldn't be so good on the auto attack as well. Sort of similar to the Soviet mortar, perhaps, should be a bit more similar to that. Did you get some S mines there, and that stopped the VP harassment down there in the south. Got a minesweeper heading down there now, though. Doesn't actually sweep these mines, as I remember the game, which is a bit curious. There are a couple still there. Not really in the most commonly used pathways, but still enough to do a lot of damage. Kind of get caught at a bad time there, just as I was leaving cover. Allows this lieutenant to win this engagement pretty handily. We see Antilles, of course, having gone for Lieutenant, going for the 50 cal. 50 cal is actually really strong these days, especially against 222s when it's got those armor piercing rounds on. Can knock them down pretty quickly. Now he spots me putting down my machine gun there. Repositioned round the side, but I had a great idea there for the follow up. And the first 222 is on the field a little bit late, but better late than never. Now I've got a 50 cal in the church. So now I'm kind of regretting having built this 222. Because him having gone for the 50 cal means that it's obviously not going to have M20, but it's also going to delay his A half track if that's the route he chooses to go, because he's not going to have enough manpower for it. So at this stage I'm kind of wishing that I had the mortar to deal with this instead of the 222, but you got to make the most of things. So I'm sending it down to the south. Let's see, what's that squad down here before? Would it help me win that engagement? But yeah, now with the 222 I really just can't even come near this region. It's good that I still have control of my cutoff, because if I didn't, the squad in the church would be causing me a few hurdles. Catches me just as I was coming around the corner there as well. Now I did go for a flamethrower, and that was right before this got into the church here, because I was expecting it only to have a rifleman in the church there, and obviously flamethrower would be a lot of help dislodging just a regular squad, but I'm not gonna, I just can't get close enough to this. Maybe if there was still that heavy cover there I might be able to, but unfortunately not the case, which did delay my medics. As you can see, I've got a lot of low health squads that's really slowing me down. But here comes the mortar. Finally gonna be dislodging this machine gun. I figure maybe I can use this to make an assault on this with my flamethrower as well. Cow going down really fast here. LMG Green's on the side, but it gets away just. Now the squad also in a bad position, having come forward to try and put a barrage on my squads. Didn't realize there was a bazooka there hiding behind that sweeper. Kind of caught me a bit off guard. Have to back away. Meanwhile, we've got two rifle squads down here in the south, capping all that territory. Still got the machine gun in a decent spot here. Cover attacks from this flank, but not from this flank.
Our opponents are seizing a sector.
It does indeed get flanked. Luckily, I've still got two grenadiers down there. Now, at least he has grenades here. I can set up and win this engagement before heading to retreat. This is a bit of a hairy engagement. The squad gets super low. Now, a somewhat common strategy as used forces these days . 50 cal got a burst off on that 222, but a somewhat common strategy as used forces these days is to go for that lieutenant into captain. Obviously that opens up getting a 50 cal, which can be very, very powerful. Well, we've already seen it's very powerful, securing that church for such a long period of time, causing all sorts of issues with a lone 222. And then if you get a call-in vehicle, that can be pretty powerful, like the Pershing after that. Especially against OKW, that's a pretty strong strategy, I feel, because they have a lot of trouble dealing with machine guns. So ISG is a little bit bad. A little bit expensive, just a little bit bad. Not much, but enough that it counts. It's quite going around the corner here, taking a lot of damage in the process. Get out. I'm like trying to get out of this building right now, but I don't, and it gets flattened. I was honestly like just doing it just as it gets flattened. Perhaps if the delay in New Zealand was a little bit better, I would have gotten away alive there. Maybe thinking, why didn't he get out there to try and get some shots off? But he's got two bazookas on that squad, as you can see, and only one squad with the actual rifle, so chance of doing damage to that squad.
Just reported pathfinders ready for action.
With basically just one rifle, very, very low. But, of course, this is recon support. Very unusual doctrine selection here. Mainly because the Greyhound is underperforming, especially against the 222. But yeah, we'll also get shredded by the Lynx as well, and the Puma. It's really underperforming at the moment, quite expensive. Costs more than the 222, and probably similar in effectiveness. It's slightly better anti-infantry. But yeah, I mean, it used to have that really OP canister shot, but canister shot did get quite heavily nerfed. Though, Rifleman Observer's pretty damn useful. And this is actually a fake smoke. But when you see these IAR pathfinders drop smoke, you get the hell out of there. And that's exactly what I do with my machine gun. You don't have time to reposition, you retreat as soon as you see that drop down. So that's a good use of the decoy smoke from Tomokaze, and I'm like, oh, well played, sir, well played. These guys very ineffective though in terms of damage, so they don't have the same infantry model sniping abilities as the pathfinders from Airborne. Did manage to secure this VP in the north because I was draining extremely quickly. Putting a lot of pressure on me, and on the right hand side of this map, whilst it is easier to hold on to your resources as Axis generally, it's a lot harder to hold on to the VP, so you can lose VPs in the early game, just quite severely, honestly. So it's something to be aware of. But until, I mean, Tomokaze has gone for major, and he's going to have a Sherman coming up very soon, but by the same process, because I've had such good fuel control this whole game. He's only cut me off once, and that wasn't really for that long. I've also ticked up, because I saw that, I think I saw the major, and I was like, oh, well, going for a Stugi is probably not a good decision here, and I've had such good fuel control. Not far off of Panzer IV myself, so I'm just going to tick up, get out of Panzer IV. Do have a pack as well. And I did manage to steal his mortar there, which was really good for me. Double mortars now. Not as useful against US forces, of course, they've got a more mobile force, not really relying on team weapons, but just denying him having the mortar is the number one benefit right now, because that thing was really a big thorn in my side. So yeah, my Panzer IV is going to be coming out soon. I've got quite a lot of munitions at the moment. Should probably have upgraded a few more of these grenadiers with LMGs, but did lose one of my algae greens in that building, remember? And with this commander, generally I like to try and save up enough munitions so I can use the Stuka close air support. Especially when you're playing against US forces medium tanks. It's a really big benefit. And it's one of the main reasons why I use this commander. Of course, it's got the smoke, which is just awesome. Recon plane, which can be useful. Tactical movement, which is really good as well. This is a lot of utility. Of course, the command Panzer IV. So he's on high explosive rounds here. Now switching over to the armor piercing. Really want to kill the squad, but no machine gun upgrade on this yet. Can't really chase it down, and there come the bazookas. Have to get out of there. 222 still doing damage here in the south, which is its main use at this stage, just trying to prevent harassment of this southern VP region. Really wanted to get this kill here, but oh, not needs a rifle squad, so it's not going to happen. And I do actually retreat my 222. Because I'm expecting him to have rotated his Sherman down here. So I didn't try to battle. I'm once again sending a lone Grenadier squad up here to try and cap. So I'm draining on VPs very, very quickly. Having a pretty good army at the moment. You see I'm actually ahead in supply. Wiped his lieutenant. I think I actually wiped him perhaps over here. He was barraging his retreat point. There is the Scott actually doing quite a lot of damage to my Sherman. I mean, to my Panzer IV. Oh no. But yeah, I got forced off down here in the south by that Sherman. But by the same token, I got this mortar here, which forced away the rifle squad that tried to cap there. So we're stalled here, which is good news for me. You may have noticed I did pick up a second Pioneer squad because I need two Pioneers now that I've got a tank on the field. Price repairs, of course, I still have rather slow repairs. So the Soviets, so having two is pretty important. Especially because this one hasn't even reached Vet 2 yet, despite having the flamethrower upgrade. Now I think at some stage I actually spot the forward retreat point back here, so I start to barrage this with my mortar. And this is a real turning point for me.
The enemy is taking our territory.
Bringing up the pack. A bit of a dangerous game if a Jackson came right now, I'd be in deep, deep trouble. Got a bazooka squad coming from the south. Got smoke just in case. And there we go, that barrage finally comes good. Major down, so is the ambulance, thanks to this mortar here, and that actually nets a Vet 3 as well. Vet 3's win against that extra range. Really become super lethal at that stage. Squad up here.
are disrupted.
Trouble. Luckily both these guys still aren't into tank. They're on high explosive. Perhaps the squad would have got wiped yet. And this is the INR-Hardy. Once again trying to get the hell out of there. Comes out very, very quickly. Two Shermans now. And I'm still quite a ways away from my next Panzer IV, so things are looking pretty grim. Do have this mine here though, so I'm really hoping that he tries to flank with the Sherman down this route so that mine comes good. But yeah, the time for going for more LMGs is kind of past at the moment. Now I'm relying on the Stukalos air support to get me back into this game to win the next engagement and win it. Win the next tank engagement and win it soundly, so I can at least capture a lot more map control, stabilize things. I saw this up here getting repaired, so I went for it next to the site provided around the capping circle. At this stage, he probably should have hit smoke. Probably could have gotten away if he'd done so. Now he pops it, but too late. Blitz. And unfortunately, I had to do like a hard turn right there. Pop smoke right as I round the corner. Blocks the line of sight for the maximum amount of time. So really good engagement there, but I lost my anti-tank gun whilst this was going on. I was trying to kill this. I kind of charged it into, well, this, because this can do a lot of damage close range, and also his 50 cal, which does a lot of damage as well. So losing my pack for a Sherman, slightly advantageous trade, because obviously I've got two mortars which can do a lot of damage to the pack, but really not ideal. Now at this stage I really want to take out this 50 cal, but I kind of derp out here. I tried to go around the back of it, but it did not work out. I think the Pathfinder got me there, and then just 50 cal does a lot of damage to the 222 these days. He actually pops a smoke barrage, which is free on the Scott, as you can see.
Taking hits. You've got to, our supply line just got cut off. Stand by.
But yeah, now I've got a second Panzer IV, so things are looking a lot better for me. Some people were asking me, because I played this on stream, like, why didn't you get the command tank? But now that it doesn't buff itself, it is a bit more vulnerable. Obviously it doesn't match up too well against a Sherman in terms of anti-tank. And if I was facing off against a Calliope, where, you know, the rockets do 80 damage, it would make a really big difference, but that's not the case. So I saw his Sherman was down here in the south, which allowed me to come in with my two Panzer IVs here, try and, well, the target was this, but end up going for the anti-tank gun instead. Managed to decrew it. Here comes the Sherman. Got a squad here ready for the Faust though. Bounce. Got his rear arm exposed. Here comes the Stukalos air support. Doesn't allow me enough munitions for the Faust anymore though. So a lot of damage to him there. That's 50 cal once again. I think I've got both mortars barraging that at the moment, but I just can't kill it. I was raging pretty hard, because I've been barraging that for a long time there and just did not kill it. Planes get shot down there. See, they fly off the map here, but if anything enters the circle for that period, these would still come back for one last hurrah. So despite not hearing them, and even a little bit after the circle disappears from the UI, they can still come back for another attack, so you got to be aware of that. So the close S4 can really cause you a few issues. Now obviously I want to repeat that effort, because that, as you can see, did buy me a lot of map control forcing off his vehicles. Managed to
enemy forces are securing our territory.
Secure a lot more map control. With a lot of time to repair both these tanks back up, so things are looking a lot better for me after dropping that, despite not killing his Sherman. Kind of ran out of steam. Perhaps I would have been able to kill it if that 50 cal had gone down.
The enemy is overrunning one of our capture points.
Might have been able to do a bit more damage there, but unfortunately that wasn't the case.
Tank destroyer is ready for action.
Ooh, Mortar's in deep trouble here. Looks like they got a kill. He's bringing his pack up. And gets decrewed by my mortars. That's my mortar there. Oh no, it's not. That's my mortar back there. That's the US mortar doing the damage. So he's managed to build a Jackson here, got two Panzer IVs here. I want to come up and kill this anti-tank gun because I don't want him to have it anymore. But I didn't know the Jackson was there, so that caused me a few issues. Brought my second Panzer IV up there. I know I took one extra shot there, kind of unnecessarily, but I was hoping to draw fire from the one that had the damaged engine. But as you can see, I've stabilized the VP situation, which is good because I'm very low on VPs, as I was saying. This right hand side of Kolodny Firmat's axis can be very hard to hold on to the VPs. Though you do have better control of your fuel, so it can lead to these situations where you're kind of just grinding the game out. You've got, you know, you end up with a slightly superior army, but a little bit behind in terms of VPs, or a lot behind in this case, probably in most cases against US forces. So, third Panzer IV going to be coming in, and once this comes in, obviously I'm going to have a huge armor advantage. So my tactics with three Panzer IVs is going to be hit and runs. I know that his infantry force is a bit low. Shouldn't be any. Shouldn't be as many anti-tanks near, so I should be able to just charge in with all three of my Panzer IVs, take out one of his vehicles, then back away. Especially with the eventual Stuka close air support saved up. Now at this stage, I'm at maximum pop cap. Got quite a bit of manpower in the bank. Should be thinking about a munitions cache for this commander, but I don't. Okay, so here's an attack. Got a Panzer IV coming in from this side. Got a Panzer IV coming in from this side. Double Panzer IVs. Going after the Jackson. Remember, this only takes three shots to kill. Missed one shot there. Pop smoke on the low health one. And get him. So mass smoke from my Panzer IVs. But this one in one control group, these other two on the other one. So mission accomplished there, really good raid by my Panzer IVs. managed to get them all away alive thanks to Panzer Tactician. That's the hit and run tactics I was talking about. So, and as I was saying, the Jackson, the best target there, because it doesn't have enough armor to bounce shots from the Panzer IV and dies in 3 shots rather than 4. I'm just stalling for time up here. And yeah, I mean, unfortunately, Tomokazu just lost a few too many rifle squads at this stage. Actually, rebuying his lieutenant. Which is a curious decision, because I feel like he kind of needs the anti-tank grenades more than he needs the munitions for the free bar. So, not sure why he did rebuild his lieutenant. Because that is the counter to mass medium tanks, being able to snare them all. And obviously he doesn't have access to mines unless he builds an M20, which he could do because he's gone lieutenant, but only Romeo would attempt that kind of strategy. No one for going for the late game M20 mines. Most famously against Paul back when the King Tiger had 400 and whatever frontal armor. I think that was on LeGlaze. So yeah, I haven't upgraded any of my Panzer IVs with machine guns either, because I want that munitions for the Stuka Close Air support. Sense weakness here, my T-gun got in position, down goes the Scott.
A gun carrier just got knocked out.
Need to pop smoke here. No dots, bad play by me. Here comes Stuka Close Air support. I've got the skirts on this one. Brought my pack up for support. And down goes that Sherman. See how, just, you know, just bring your pack up for support. And dropping the Stuka Close Air support really helps win those engagements. He brought his pack around the side here. Maybe if a few more of those bazookas had hit, that would have been the end of my pick 3. As Foy tries to bring his Sherman back in. Kind of lucky that I'd removed my pack. Let's bring it back for here and try to bring it in for the last hit. Attack ground misses. Yeah, I think I had sight of his Sherman there, because he has the 50 cal upgrade on it, and I think I was shooting at my planes, that's why I had sight of it there. So yeah, I mean, overall Tomokazu has just been getting picked off by these double mortars, by my medium tank raids, and of course by the Circulus air support. So I've just been grinding out. The army advantage, and yeah, as I was saying, I should have made munitions caches probably a while back now, but oh well. Still a bit rusty, I haven't been playing that much recently. So, oh, I have been the last maybe week, but before that, when the US mortar was really broken, I wasn't really playing much.
Points are down to 300.
They're trying to outflank us. Troop concentration. They got our range.
So now I've got a huge army size advantage. He's just about out of fuel. Got the triple cap. Bring my machine gun up. slightly more aggressive position, try to shut down this entire region here. Still leaving this side exposed, but that's where we've got grenadiers and medium tanks for, depending on the other avenues. Some people are saying, why didn't you go in for the kill on that, that Sherman, because it was extremely low after taking that stupidly support burst, but still got these bazooka re-echelons, so I almost certainly would have lost my panic for if I was going to do that, and there's no guarantee I would even kill the Sherman, because if I took engine damage, probably could have gotten away. And there goes the last Sherman, thanks to this pack, target weak point. Go get to see some slightly off-meter doctrines here from both players. Nice to see. Nice to see some medium tank play from Ossie as well. You get tired of seeing the old Stuggy into Tiger calling meta. And really, that was kind of a fraud to me because obviously I spawned on this right-hand side with the more secure fuel. But yeah, as I was saying, it is a lot harder to hold onto these VPs, which is why I got into such a really tough spot in that respect. And yeah, maybe I should have got more LMGs, my grenadiers, a bit earlier, and also gone for some munitions caches. If a Tomokaze, I mean, props for him for trying to go recon support, and I didn't really make note of it, but those riflemen observers that, when our riflemen are standing in cover, they gain the extra sight. Actually really good for him, but he just needed to tighten up his game. Just a few too many losses. Especially that mortar. That was a real turning point when I stole his mortar and turned it against him. That was a really big turning point for me. Anyway, guys, I'll wrap on that. If you'd like your game to be cast by me, details are in the video description below. Otherwise, I'll catch you all for the next thrilling installment. Goodbye and good luck.